can only be one king.
Recycling out yet? I gotta
do you want to do it now?
Yeah, I gotta do that.
Gonna do it right now?
Yeah.
All right, we gotta take.
I'll be right back.
It's warm up. I'm just taking out that Corbin's trash.
Usually, I have people to come over and do this for the king, but I gave him the day off.
King's car right here. Look at this for a palace. Tow truck guy.
Yep, I'm gonna handle this.
Yeah, the car's getting towed to the garage. So this is another part of a back workout because we actually are pushing with our backs
in our back of our hamstrings. Good old Mercedes.
All right, thanks, man.
Yeah, no problem.
All right. We're getting rid of the Mercedes, going to a more royal, acceptable car. We're gonna get a fleet of Rolls Royces. Right? That's what you got. You bought yourself when you became king.
Yeah, I got the two of them around the mantelpiece.
Yeah, good.
Here we go. How's it going? I'm Sheamus, AKA the Celtic Warrior, and welcome to Celtic Warrior Workouts. We have an awesome royal Brave Change workout today because we are with WWE Superstar and current King of the Ring, Baron Corbin. What's the crack, fella?
We don't get too many applauses.
No, right? No, let's give ourselves applause. Yeah.
I'm used to booing.
What's the crack, man? How you doing?
Good. Glad you came out today. We're doing the royal workout in the new gym with current circumstances, people have had to adjust. And
COVID-19 running wild with its 24-inch pythons all over the world. Come on, have a look at it. So this is pretty awesome. Now, the last work I did was with Jinder, but people have like literally adapted their homes into workout. We've got some pretty great heavy-duty equipment here. You can see, check it out, Jason. Look at that. Arsenal Strength, which is one of the biggest weightlifting manufacturing companies in the States. Lex Lewis is involved with them, they're really, really cool. Great camera work there, JL. You're doing brilliant, look at that. So unlike Drew McIntyre's lap pull-down machine, which he only had lap pull-down, Corbin's actually got like a low pulley rope. So Drew, if you're watching, mate.
This is the difference between a king and a peasant, is the low rope.
You know, I've noticed that in all your promos, you're just very relaxed. You enjoy talking about, like, letting people know how good you are, how rich you are, how confident you are, and how you do say you are, it's debatable, but like, you're the best, greatest king of the ring of all time. I will give you that. And I will give you the fact, like, the one thing that's missing in our business sometimes is the fact that people want to be a heel, a bad guy, as they say. There's a lot of people who say they want to be a heel, and but they want to be cheered.
Then they realize people don't like them, and they're like, wait a second, I don't like that.
Yes.
But I love that.
You love it. You live for that, right?
I revel in the booze, and I just, people that get so angry that they're like, oh no, he's a terrible person. He's not just a bad guy on TV, he's a terrible person. I hate him, his whole family. I love that.
It's great. You know? There's nothing like being hated, man. Before you came to WWE, you played for the Arizona Cardinals, yep. NFL team. Obviously, you've taken that that physical aspect of your training, of the competitive sport, into WWE, and you've thrived in. Do you want to talk about that? Like,
I grew up playing football. That's just what we did, and I grew up, you know, playing football and boxing, and football started to pay for college, and then it paid me. So it was one of those things where it was a lifestyle and a training, same as with WWE and you know, any professional level sport. The training has to be your life, you know. It's very difficult to maintain the strength, the speed, the size, all of that in the NFL, especially for me because I was an offensive lineman. I was 330 pounds when I was in Arizona.
What are you now?
I'm right 265 yesterday because I'm in that weight loss challenge right now.
Right.
But I usually run around about 275 is my comfortable weight. But I was 330, so I was training. I mean, I was benching 500, I was squatting 700. I was running a sub 540, which is insane for someone that big.
For someone, for people that don't know,
I ran a 498. Was my 40-yard dash, which is crazy because most O linemen are like 5'1", 5'2". So okay. I was moving.
That's insane.
That's a train on the tracks, and if you're in the way, bye bye. So, but that's what I had to train for. I mean, I was eating pizza at midnight or milkshakes and stuff like that to maintain that weight, because if I didn't hit, you know, 10,000 calories in a day, it seemed like, I don't know how many it was, and I wasn't counting. I was just eating as many as I could. But I'm gonna guess, because I'm counting calories now, it was probably in the 10,000 range.
Wow.
Otherwise, I would lose 3 pounds in a day because I was just so big.
Can I say, like, did you even enjoy, you must have, like, you know, for a lot of people, like, they enjoy their cheat meal and stuff like that, but you probably didn't enjoy eating at all, did you?
No, I loved it. I was a fat kid, dude. Like, I was a big fat guy. How can you not love pizza, onion rings, milkshakes? I had, like, a bag of Oreos in the fridge all the time.
What?
Like, yeah, dude. Because I wouldn't have enjoyed eating if it was all healthy food.
Okay.
Because that's so, like, I've tried to do it with only healthy foods, especially in college when I was like 320, and you're eating 10 chicken breasts and 20 eggs, and I just wanted to puke. Yeah. So then when I got to the pros, they're like, we need to put like 8 to 10 more pounds on you. I was like, I can't physically eat any more chicken or whatever. So then I moved into the bad stuff. There was like a corner store by my house that had hot dogs. Best hot dogs in the world. I get 2 hot dogs, onion rings, and a milkshake every day when I was driving home.
Holy shit, that's awesome.
It was so good.
It's my dream job right there.
Just eating. But then coming to WWE, everything had to change. You know, they told me on my trial, you got to lean out, you got to lose weight, you got to be more aesthetic, because I was just a big round dude, man.
Yeah.
And
well, you're taking people out, man. You're just running them over.
Yeah, you know, that's what I was paid to do. Just be as big as possible and move fast. And so I dropped. I mean, when I came for my trial, I was down almost 50 pounds, or when I signed. So I went from 330 to 280 and probably 6 months.
That's crazy.
Just all diet.
Yeah.
And it's hard too, because I still get caught up. I mean, even now, I have to hold myself very accountable what I'm eating, because I can't out-train my diet.
Right.
Like, I train hard in the weight room. I've always trained hard in the weight room and always been a big, like, training guy. But you can't out-eat or out-train a bad diet. I learned that hard way.
You hear that, kids?
Yes. Maybe when you're 18. Maybe when you're 18, you can eat whatever you want and then you're good. But when you start to get older, I mean, you know that, like, we enjoy our whiskey. I can't go have a bottle of whiskey every night and be in top shape. I can't train harder than that. So
maybe when we're at the end.
Yeah, right?
No, it's true. I definitely think, I agree with that. It's just like, this is a situation where, like, I have dropped calories too. I was at 275. When I was in FCW, I was 295.
You were huge. I saw
that. I was like round, and it was like stuff hanging out over the back of the tights and the front of my tights. But you're right, it is all about diet as well as training. Did you find, like, with NXT, it was a hard to make a change, or was it an easy adjustment for you?
So for me, I think the biggest thing is I break it down into two parts. Like, coming in the door, the physicality, the training, the mental discipline was cake.
Like, right.
To get in, get in the ring, hey, here's how you move. Okay, oh, he's got it. Okay, what's next?
Okay.
You know, like, I mean, I'm picking the in-ring stuff up really, really well, really fast. You know, I could run circles around some guys. And just because I think of what I've gone through in life with all that athletic background, you know, some guys have just wanted to be a WWE superstar their whole life, where I was, you know, playing football, I was boxing, I was, you know, doing all kinds of stuff.
Golden Gloves too, actually.
Three-time champion.
Three-time Golden Gloves champion right there. It's crazy.
So all of that was super simple. But then now, for me, the other side was the conveying emotion through promos, through in the ring, with, you know, getting beat up. Because when you're growing up playing sports, you're always taught, don't show a weakness, don't show you're tired, don't show pain, like, no emotion, you're stone cold on the field.
Right.
Because you don't want your opponents to know, especially in a boxing ring, like, if you're hurt, you don't want them to know you're hurt, or they don't want you tired. So that was the thing that was very difficult, I think, was coming into FCW and NXT was showing emotion, whether it be in the promo, because you sit me down with ESPN, do an interview, no problem, crush it, but then you hand me this and go, this is how you feel, this is what you're saying, then it's kind of a game changer. I mean, it's hard. It's really hard.
It is hard, and that's why it's
uncomfortable.
I agree with that. That's why there's a lot of people who don't, you know, make that next level, jump, because it's everybody can lift loads of weight and everybody can great shape and everybody can be great athletes to train, but when you're tapping into the emotional side of yourself, of what the character is and what the character's going through. I mean, I remember we did a thing with Roman, and they had the dog, like, you enjoyed it. It was great, you know, like a typical heel. You like douse Roman with dog food and stuff, and then of course they got you back. And that, I remember you coming to the locker room, fella. You're just covered. Looked like you're covered in shit.
Yes, like,
yeah, and you just walked in.
I threw all those clothes away.
I thought you walked in fully clothed in the shower and just
did. I did, but like the shoes came off and threw them in the trash, the pants, everything.
All right, done with the talking. We're about to get into the workout stuff. So Corbin, what's the plan with this Royal Wing workout?
We're gonna build some wings, man.
That's some wings.
We're gonna start with some rack deadlift, kind of a warm up, kind of explosive, trying to get your hips through when you're lifting. To help build that deadlift stronger and stronger. We're in week two of my new building program, so we're hitting the back day in this. Then we've got some straight arm cable pull downs where you're gonna pull that to the hips, work that lat.
And the wings.
It's gonna be supersetted with lat pull downs where we're gonna build some royal wings. That's what we're doing. Then we're gonna pop down the ground and we're gonna do the seated cable rope. The thing that Drew McIntyre does not have, and I do, we're gonna hit that. Then we're gonna hit some bent over underhand rows.
Yeah. Who doesn't like bent over underhand rows, huh?
We're gonna build up these monsters back here. Then we got a little like kind of hit training cardio. We're gonna hit that bar where we hit the six high pulls. Then you're gonna do six jerks, six squats, six RDLs. Three sets of that. We're gonna hit those nice, get that heart rate up. We're gonna finish with some eccentric leg raises, get that core, and then I'm gonna introduce you to my battle rope over there.
Awesome.
And we're gonna do some partner seated rows, just trying to bury each other. We're just gonna try to destroy till someone cries. Usually we do it over here, Etor starts laughing, then crying, and I win. So yeah, we're gonna see what happens.
All right. Let's get to it!
Like,
how many sets of these?
We're gonna do three by 10. Okay. So we're gonna get to a weight you feel comfortable with.
Three sets of 10.
You gotta, you know, your channel motivates people. You gotta put the work in. So I even have here Arsenal Strength with them. It says Farm Your Keep
right here. Is that your logo thing?
It's on my skin too.
Holy
shit. It's in my skin.
I mean, check it out.
It takes a lot of time to, you know, build a base just like it does a farm from Kansas. So
this is customized here, Farm Your Keep.
Gotta put the work in to get it.
Mine's brake change.
Bam!
I don't think I'm gonna get brake change on my leg.
Bam, you should do it.
Yeah.
You should do it. I'd get a guy over here. We can do it. So I think this would probably be a good weight for these. Just trying to still keep that explosiveness in there. You know, get a little wiggle. Feeling good. You like the angle? How do I look? My arms look big in this angle. Yeah. Good little grip. I'm back. I forget the number 7 a lot, so I don't get anywhere from 9 to 11 when they're supposed to be 10. But you know, we do what we can do. When you're doing these rack pulls, you want it right below your knee, at knee level.
Because since I'm shorter than you, and
yeah, I wasn't going to say that out loud, but get it. Sweat today, Shamo. We're gonna sweat. It's humid here in Florida. I'm gonna come to Nashville. We're gonna do a box.
I look at the comb. It's great, Bernard. It's awesome.
I saw you doing your mitt work. We gotta fix one of your punches. I don't remember which one it is.
Probably all of them.
I got you. Last set. Shoot. Shoot. Nice. Not bad, right? Not bad.
Awesome.
Blood's flowing.
Definitely. Like, the thing I like about that as well, like, it's getting everything going, you know, your glutes, your back, your arms, your shoulders, your legs, warms up everything. Okay, what's next?
four sets, supersetted. We got 12 of the pulling to your hips, and then
pull down. That
pull down. Yeah, yeah. We're gonna get down in this one. We're gonna be, you know, this is gonna require some changing because we've only got one machine, so we're just gonna have to do it. All right, so this will be our superset.
How many reps?
12 to 10.
Okay.
So we're gonna be 12 here. Engaging the lats, the core. And then pop up. Switch it. Boom. A little superset action. This is not a workout for peasants. That's for sure. So if you're weak in the heart, don't even try. Because here we go. We got 10 of these. Yeah. So there we go. Little back. Lean, right. Boom to the hips. There it is. That's it. See, this is where the leans come in.
They come in.
Dang, you lean. What are you, 210? 205? You want a 205 line?
Well, I haven't won that tight yet.
Oh.
Reese feels
that. That's good. That's good. It's the same weight my wife does. We got four sets here. That's fine. Come on with it. There it is. You want to get back to that royal level, my friend. This is where we be. This is where we be. We've nicknamed this garage about 20 different things, but right now, its nickname is the Dungeon of Doom.
Dungeon of Doom.
Because I love the movie
D.O.D.
and the Temple of Doom, where he's like ripping people's hearts out. This is the Dungeon of Doom. But I do have my King of the Ring, but I also have a collection of human skulls right inside that door.
That's nice.
So what you think about that?
It's awesome.
Hey! Come back. Hey!
A little more. Yeah, there you go. Nice.
And Bobby Lashley is extremely strong.
What did he bench?
I mean, on incline, we got up to like 365, and he wasn't struggling.
Hell.
It was impressive.
Oh my God.
I've also seen E one time in Philly, went in the gym. He was floor pressing 405 for 10. 405 pounds, 10 times.
I saw a picture of myself after I did a workout with Conga Fitness, and I had the idea where like I put a load of weight on, like, you know, I felt like, you know, I put weight on, a bit more mass on, go into the, like, I felt like I just wanted to get up like the Brock yeah. era, the Braun, like, way. And I saw, I took my tank top off, and I saw this big, bleeding, white, pasty white Ned Kelly belly just staring back at me. And I was like, you know what? This was not a good idea. So I was like, I did the opposite, and I just like went down the other way. So like, I can't like look big, at least if I look leaner, I may look aesthetically bigger.
Yeah.
And I feel better too, because I cut out dairy, I cut out gluten, which has stopped blood inflammation in my neck and stuff like that on my joints, which I feel better.
Right.
And I just feel much better. I feel like I move better in the ring, on a boxer now as well.
Yeah.
Like no matter how much I eat, like I'm still gonna burn all those calories because I'm just working so much. Yeah. Cameraman Jason doing a great job. Jay, I'm saying hello to everybody.
What's up?
Hell of a job.
And you can only play in blood and sweat. There you go. go. Oh, I like it. I like it. You like it?
I love it.
I like it.
I love it. Great crack.
You know, I like your shirt. I just realized you're wearing a Brave Change shirt. I was gonna say, why didn't you bring me a shirt? But you brought
I didn't
me
know your size.
You brought me a bottle of whiskey, which is...
I need to get 2X, right?
No, I'm a 1. Hey, yeah. Drew McIntyre, if you're watching this, this is what mine does, and yours doesn't.
Yeah. It's this Tampa weather, man. I never used to it.
15! We're doing 15 reps!
We're doing 15 reps!
3 sets!
You have a path with your arse on, and I'm just doesn't go numb.
I mean, if you're a baby, babies need pads. Oh, there we go. 4, 5, 6, 7, 8.
Yeah, spot,
I
just spot
I feel the heat of your loins.
Spot you there.
Oh, Captain, you dick. Hey. I felt the Celtic Warrior behind me.
Was that 15?
I think so. I don't know. I was distracted by the giant white thighs behind me.
Man, they say no distractions, bro. You gotta keep your concentration. Arnie says the bomb going off in the gym shouldn't distract me from your set.
Oh my god. Do you want me to drop the weight down for you?
No.
You sure?
Yeah.
You're turning a nice shade of red there.
Oh, it's me in summer.
We're not in sun though. We're whooping it up. See, you got a green whoop strap.
Oh,
come on, Corbin, knock it out. 11, 12, 13. If you can't do the reps right, because it's too heavy, don't do them. Drop the weight and get it right, right?
Yeah.
11, 12, 13, 14.
Come on, Corpse.
15. There it is. Come on with it. Look at the veins. You got roadmaps in your arms, man. Some roadmaps. Feel good?
Yeah. I never felt better.
You look great.
Never felt better.
You look great.
Thank you. How many sets? It's 3 sets of this?
3x8 with a pause at the top. Okay. Nice little hold.
Guys, if you can avoid using these, use them. I've had hand surgery, tore, snap.
Those are basically the fingerless gloves of old ladies in the gym. I'm teasing. You have hand surgery. It's okay.
Yeah, I snapped the tendon here. So anyway, listen, if you can avoid using, you know what,
you I'm just, the first you time with it. That one, the thumb that holds the thumb there?
Yeah.
I tore that one too.
Oh, yeah, so I took a tendon out of here and put it in here. So I just
left it unattached.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Okay, well, maybe I'll just throw it out the wrap. I think Vince, when I told Vince like what happened, he goes, I didn't hit it too hard. He goes, you go, sure. I was like, what?
Alright, this one we got some underhand grip, get a little bicep involved, a little pause here at the top. There it is, just like that. Ah. Ah. 6, 7, 8. Oh, those aren't rubber plates. Don't drop those.
Yeah, it's underhand, right?
Yes. Nice pause at the top.
Ah, shit.
Nice little pause. There it is. Oh man, you look so strong right now. Not bad for a second rate king. Not bad. Oh, okay. 6, 7. Pull this right into that belly button.
I christened your gym.
That's jet fuel.
Royal Airspace.
Yes. That's it. That fancy jet fuel.
Consider your gym the dungeon of doom christened. I stick to it for like 6 month periods. And what I do is I take about
about 2,500 calories in a day, maybe less. And then 2 days before TV, I spike them up. So my protein fats stay the same. Protein 270, fat 90, and low days carbs are like 175 for 5 days. And then on Saturday, Sunday, if we're taping on a Monday, I'll have 375 grams of carbs on the new day. So by the time I get to TV, I just look fuller.
Okay.
Because I've depleted my body of carbs.
Yeah.
I fill up and my body just takes them in like a sponge. So I'll go out looking bigger. And then by the time Wednesday comes, I'm back down again.
Burnt, yeah.
Yeah, deflated.
I'm with it.
So it works. It works great. Just manipulating carbohydrates.
So I'm in that weight loss program right now. Yeah. Guess how many calories I'm taking in a day?
Jesus. Don't tell me it's like 2,000.
It's less.
Holy shit.
I've been running between 1,800 and 2,000 calories a day. For me, that is astronomically low, and it is crushing my energy.
Yeah.
But right now, I've dabbled with diets since I left football because it's hard. My body is carb sensitive.
Too many of it, Jay.
But I also have to be careful because I lost so much weight, my skin has stretched.
Right.
And if I get too flat too quick, my skin will sag, like, because it just hasn't healed.
Okay.
And I'm hoping now to get down low enough where I can let it heal. You know, with the schedule we're on, it's a little different. So I'm trying to actually get down to 265 now. I'd like to get below 260 and then build back up to 270.
It's a great idea.
I've done the whole no carb diet. I've done high fat, high protein. I've done intermittent fasting. I've done all these different diets, and it's just come down to calories.
Yeah, that's so, all it is, calorie deficit. If you're in a calorie deficit, you're gonna lose weight.
Yeah, and then you're sweating like this.
Last set, come on.
Here we go.
There we go,
come on. Now this one is all essentially some constant movement. We want to get that blood flowing. We want to burn some calories here. It's kind of a finisher for the workout because we've done a good job of building those lats, those traps, that upper back. This is more for just keeping that endurance for what we do. We work in bursts in the ring. This kind of helps keep that cardio because it's hard to train on the streets for that bursted cardio. So this is something that's constant movement when you're having to pick people up, move people around. This is one of those things that we'll separate the kings from everybody else. So we're gonna hit 8 high pulls in a row, and yeah, then we're gonna go to 8 jerks. We're gonna hit 8 squats, 8 RDLs, just like this. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Back to the back. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. That's it. That's the set. It's lighter weight. It's getting that heart rate spike. That feels good.
I forgot about these.
8 high pulls. There we go. Hit that. There we go. There we go. Nice. Hit them squats. Hit them. We're sweating today, baby. We're sweating today. Come on. Come on. Like it, I like it. I'm gonna check my heart rate here just because I wanna know. I'm at 108, right? 107, coming down off that. We'll let it get down below 90, and then we'll go again. When you get that heart rate to spike and drop, it's equivalent, you know, you do, realistically, you get into like 10, 12 hit training where you're spiking that heart rate, bringing it down. You're gonna be doing, it'd be like doing a half hour, 45 minutes on a treadmill, right?
That's cool, yeah.
We're gonna run it back here. Hey, hey, hey. 4, 5, 6, 7,
8, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8.
Awesome.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8.
I'm at the 140 right now. Climbing a little bit. There we go. There we go. Let's go, let's go.
NXT.
Yeah.
Chinese girl, yeah.
Yeah, she did some crazy.
She destroyed me, man.
Yeah.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. I wanted to. I was ducking off camera, trying to not to puke. I was dying. I want to see what she did, man.
What were you. I mean, I'm going to watch that one today.
You should watch it. She did a lot of things, man. And a lot of these. I can't even remember at this stage, but I'd never been so blown up in my entire life. And that was after I got in the ring for my comeback. I wrestled with Drew Gulak and Cesaro for an hour and a half. So I was already blown up. But then I got in there with her and she just finished me off. Like with a fucking with a sword right to the head.
Last set.
Let's do it. Awesome, dude.
Get them RDLs in.
Get that ass on his ass. You can do it, put your ass into it. That sweat dripping off him.
You need it. It's good for you. Come on now. There we go. There we go. Get them reps in. Come on. Come on. Hell yeah, let's go. Finish it. Finish it.
Money did Big E contribute to the gym?
$0! Nitty comes in here and he talks shit because Kofi Kingston's dumbbells go to 120 pounds and mine only go to 100. You know what? The doors might be closed to you now, Big E. Especially after you no-showed today to go to LA Fitness.
He's going to LA. He didn't say fitness, he says, I'm going to LA to train legs. He's like, that's a hell of a commitment right there.
You're going to grip the rope and I'm going to pull your arms straight.
Right.
So now,
here?
You're going to do a row. So you row while I fight, just your arms.
On my arms?
Yep, just like that. And I'm going to fight you and I'm going to row it back while you fight me.
Oh,
that's what we're going to do. Okay?
Yeah.
All right.
I thought we started already. How do you beat Big E at this game?
You gotta try to make him laugh.
Oh, okay.
Because that's only he starts laughing, he loses his strength.
Really?
We fired it up because the last set is always the best set. Hit it! Hey! Come on, baby! Oh!
host and exercise.
Yeah.
I appreciate it.
That's how we do.
Thanks for having me in your home.
Now we do what real men do.
And we get a shot of whiskey.
Yeah. As customary, for me out here, for everybody who does Celtic Warrior workouts, I just want to say, Baron, having me in your home, working out in your gym.
That's a good amount of sweat.
You've earned it, fella.
Thank you. I'll hang it up just like this. I got a new, will you sign it later?
Yeah, sure.
You know?
It's normally 10 bucks, but I can.
Thank you, brother. I want to see if my shirt does as much.
I'll get your proper shirt. I'll send you your shirt.
That's some work! Yeah!
How are we doing?
It's gonna be a Royal Brave Change workout with current King of the Ring.
Two kings in one place! Sounds like you boys need a King Slayer! Right? Right?
No. No.
Sorry about that.
Maybe next time.
Yeah.
The second best ever King of the Ring, Baron Corbin, is going to be on my YouTube channel showing us how he works out. Right, fellas?
He actually wants some views, so he's bringing the best king on the channel.
I'm the greatest ever King of the Ring.
No, I'm... Look at my fur. You don't have any fur.
I'm the Celtic King, fella. What are you talking about? I'm the greatest King of the Ring of all time.
There can only be... One King!